mortared all these old walls around here. We've got office space that we're dedicating to law enforcement, and we just raised the law enforcement flag out here because at the state fairgrounds and all over Mississippi, here in the city of Jackson and Hinds County and all over Mississippi, our number one priority, number one goal is to keep people safe. And we're geared up exactly 2 weeks from today. 2 weeks from today, we're going to have the Mississippi State Fair kickoff at 11 o'clock, October the 6th through the 16th. You may not realize, but it is the largest event in the state of Mississippi. We've had great fairs over the years. We've had great success. And all of that's because of the partnership and the working relationship we have with our law enforcement. We've got so many agencies represented here today. Can we just thank our law enforcement right now? Thank you all. Thank you so much. We appreciate you. Thank you for what you're doing. With us today is Jimmy Herzog, who's our Chief of Security, Mississippi State Fairgrounds, Colonel Randy Ginn, the Director of the Mississippi Highway Patrol. We have Lieutenant Colonel Lee Morrison with the Mississippi Highway Patrol Mounted Patrol. They're outside the door right there. Chief Bo Lucky with Mississippi State Capitol Police. Chief Ricky Davis with our State Fire Marshal's Office. Hinds County Sheriff Tyree Jones. Chief James Davis with Jackson Police Department. And we also have Colonel Jerry Carter, Mississippi Department of Wildlife, Fisheries and Parks. And Baxter Kruger, the Director of Mississippi Homeland Security, Executive Director, and Jim Brinson, who's the Assistant Director. If I missed anybody, I'm sorry. We do have our Agriculture Department, Mississippi Agriculture and Livestock Theft Bureau, Chief Dean Bernard's right over here. Thank you, Chief, for what you do. And as you see, we're going to have today multiple agencies. And the message of the day is we are all working together to keep Mississippi's State Fair safe, to keep the public safe here, both inside the fairgrounds and outside the fairgrounds. We welcome you today. We express our great appreciation. We couldn't do what we do at the fairgrounds every day without our local jurisdictions, Hinds County SO, Sheriff's Office, Sheriff Jones, Chief James Davis. Over the years, both of y'all have done a great job. I know the Hinds County SO's Mounted Patrol was in force during the Dixie National Rodeo and also during the Black Rodeo this summer. And we appreciate all the work you're doing. For the State Fair, which is a large event, the largest event in the state, we've got the Mississippi Highway Patrol's Mounted Patrol Unit under the command of Lieutenant Colonel Lee Morrison. They're going to be joining you in that. And we're excited because we're in the middle of transforming this 105-acre complex into a great livestock show venue, state fair, carnival, amusement rides, and of course, great fair food. But our number one goal is fair safety and public safety. We are very honored to have been part of the water response. I want to thank all of our law enforcement who've assisted with that. The water distribution that was conducted here on the fairgrounds while that was going on with the National Guard. We were very honored to be a part of that. And then also even now we have some space that we've dedicated to warehousing some water for public distribution as the water crisis gets in the rearview mirror. And as you know, we have our own water well here at the State Fairgrounds. We will have fresh water during the State Fair, and we invite the public to come. I want to thank our fairgrounds team. They've been so committed to helping the people of Jackson and Hinds County throughout this water crisis, and also the National Guard and our Highway Patrol and Capitol Police and local jurisdiction sheriff and JPD as well. This Army will serve as a security command center for the fairgrounds. It is available to each and every law enforcement agency that will be a part of the security team here. We will have a security team like never before here at the State Fair in 2022. As we've done in the past, we're partnering with our local jurisdictions, Hinds County and JPD, and we are excited about the additional staff that we're going to have with the state law enforcement, the Department of Public Safety, Department of Wildlife, Fisheries and Parks, Homeland Security doing what they do behind the scenes, State Fire Marshal, Commissioner Cheney, State Fire Marshal, y'all always are helpful to us. We appreciate that. Ricky Davis will speak in just a minute. And I really appreciate everyone being here. Let me boil it down. I'm going to cover our new security measures in just a moment. But the bottom line is this. We are not going to be controlled by a few criminals. We're not going to let a few bad actors. In the state of Mississippi. We say that every year, but I believe it's especially true today. And I'm going to be here at the state fair each and every day. I'll be giving some biscuits out starting every day. And my family's going to be here. And I promise you, we wouldn't be here. And we will be here. We ask you to join us for the state fair. Different agencies that I've mentioned partnering together, pulling the same direction. Security staff and the new security measures that are 2022. Didn't just pull out of thin air. These are measures that our chief of security, Jimmy Herzog, has consulted with around the country. What you're going to hear today are issues and measures that have been taken by America, and we think that they Mississippi State Fair. State Fair will be throughout the fairgrounds and security officers throughout the year. There will only be 7 entry points to the 7 entry points, funnel points. If it goes through the midway, we'll go through those points. In place, and on top of that, we have video surveillance running state fairgrounds, and we really appreciate everybody working behind the scenes. Based on our, I would mention Homeland Security helped us conduct this assessment through the Department of Public Safety. I really appreciate Commissioner Sean Tindall, all of you and your team, and Capitol Police, State Capitol Police, Bo Lucky. Thank you all for helping, and all of us have really appreciated the insights you brought from the other parts of the country. One of the things we've noticed at the State Fair in recent years is late at night, when the fair is open, we do have from time to time large numbers of unsupervised youth who come in late at night without adult supervision, and other fairs have had the same type of issue. So this year, for the first time, people need to know that after 9 o'clock p.m., youth will be required to have adult supervision when they come through the gates. In other words, after 9 o'clock, every guest may be asked to show official ID that they are of age, that they're 21 years of age. And if they're not, then they need to have a responsible adult with them, 21 years of age or older. We're going to be enforcing that at each of the 7 entry points. Those entry points will maintain a metal detector, so anyone who is carrying an unlawful weapon, any unlawful individual, underage people who are carrying weapons like we've seen in the past, they will be detected and they will be dealt with immediately. All bags will be subject to check. We have a maximum bag size that we're putting in place. And of course, as always, no outside food or beverage, no marketing, no soliciting, no political vending items allowed unless authorized under fairground regulations. No animals other than service animals are as authorized by fair management for fair activities. No banners, fireworks, explosives, or laser pointers allowed. I would mention this. We do have, as you mentioned, as I already talked about, the Mounted Patrol Units, Hines SO, Mississippi Highway Patrol will be on the fairgrounds, and the State Fire Marshal's Office is providing a group of trained canine units, dogs, that were very highly qualified and trained to detect any suspicious activity. They'll be on site as well. Pursuant to state law, the legal carry of firearms for all lawful adults is recognized. We're not changing the law on that. We have that in the state law. And we have, of course, to apply common sense, exceptions that can be granted based on fair security and fair management. Bottom line on these new procedures for unsupervised youth late at night, the fairgrounds is not here to babysit youth late at night who may get into bad activities. We are going to put these procedures in place. We invite everyone, anyone and everyone to come to the state fair. But if you're underage, you need to come to the fair earlier and not after 10, 11, you know, late at night, as we've seen these patterns in the past. At this time, I want to recognize our Chief of Fairground Security, Chief Jimmy Herzog. Come around here, Chief, and say a few words. I appreciate all the good work that you put into this plan, and I want to mention this. We're going to talk about general aspects of our security plan today, but we're not getting into the details. It is a confidential law enforcement plan. We don't want our plan to fall into the hands of the enemies, of the bad guys. But we want the bad guys to understand, if you come to the fairgrounds, expect to be dealt with. We will deal with, and we will not tolerate, any criminal activity of any sort on the state fairgrounds, during the state fair, or any other time. Chief Herzog, thank you for what you do. Say a few words for us. Appreciate you.
Can y'all hear me?
There you go.
Good morning. My name is Jimmy Herzog. I'm the Chief of Security here at the Mississippi State Fairgrounds. First of all, we are excited to announce numerous agencies that will be partnering with the Mississippi State Fairgrounds to assure a safe and fun environment for the public. I want to introduce the agencies that we will be partnering with. The first is the Ag Def Bureau, Hinds County Sheriff's Office, Jackson Police Department, Capitol Police, Mississippi Highway Patrol, Mississippi State Fire Marshal's Office, Mississippi Department of Wildlife, Fisheries, and Parks, and Homeland Security. Without disclosing our operational plan, each agency will play a vital role that will provide resources that will assure order and safety at the fair. I would like to personally thank each agency involved that will provide these necessary tools to accomplish our mission. Again, thank you very much.
Thank you, Chief.
Yes, sir.
Appreciate you. Thank you so much. Give Jimmy a hand. He's been working hard since he came on board in June. And at this time, I want to recognize Colonel Randy Ginn, my friend. Thank you for being here. Come and share a few words. Again, I want to express my personal appreciation to our governor, to the Commissioner of Public Safety, Sean Tindall. And Colonel Ginn, thank you for everything you have done, everything you are doing to keep the people of Mississippi safe. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Commissioner. Good morning. It is a pleasure for me to stand before you this morning representing the Mississippi Highway Patrol. And I want to say thanks to the Commissioner for inviting us to be a part of this team that will work to ensure the safety of anybody who wants to come and enjoy the fair and to bring their family for the fun and excitement that the Mississippi State Fair always has been. It's been our mission at the Highway Patrol since 1938 to be a support and a partner with law enforcement agencies all over this state to provide the resources and the personnel that they may need to help them in accomplishing the mission that they have. And that's what we're doing here. It's been our instruction from Governor Reeves and from Commissioner Tindall since day one to take the partnerships that we have, to grow them, and to be an active participant in events where our assistance and our expertise is needed. And that's what we're doing here. And we're very pleased to work with Hinds County SO, with Jackson Police Department and their officers, and then with all the other state agencies that are represented here to work to accomplish the mission that's set before us. And that's simply to provide a safe and enjoyable atmosphere to anybody who wants to come and enjoy the Mississippi State Fair. So Commissioner, again, thank you for including us in this. And we look forward to working with you and with everyone else to accomplish the goal. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate you. Thank you. Chief Bo Lucky is the newly installed State Capitol Police Chief. Chief Lucky, I think he's been on the job, maybe a couple of months now? And we appreciate what you have done and what you are doing. And these folks have been partners with us here at the fairgrounds for multiple events along with Hinds and JPD. So Chief Lucky, welcome, and thank you for being a part of this.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Good morning, everybody. My name's Chief Bo Lucky, Capitol Police. First, I'd like to say thank you, Commissioner Gibson, for allowing me to be here today and talk about some things that we want to accomplish here at the State Fair to make sure everybody's safe. Also want to bring attention to Capitol Police and the things that we've done so far. When Capitol Police was brought under the Mississippi Department of Public Safety, main goal was to make sure that anybody visiting the Capitol Complex Improvement District felt safe. Whether that's working, whether you're coming here to enjoy some of the fine restaurants in the area or visit some of the retail sites, or whether you're coming to visit the most productive attraction in the state of Mississippi, the State Fair. And we have worked tirelessly to do this, to make this happen. I would like to thank those that are here today, Chief Davis, Jackson Police Department, Sheriff Tyree Jones, Hinds County Sheriff's Department, for making every bit of success and progress that we've had so far possible. This is a joint effort. This is a team effort. We have worked together quite a bit on several things, and they have been there by our side every step of the way. Also, we have also tried to be there for them. The State Fair is going to be no different. We're going to continue our efforts working together, building this united front so that the criminal element knows that they're not going to come here and run off the good citizens that want to enjoy a good family event. We want everybody here to feel safe. And certainly with the partnerships we have, with the security plan in place that Commissioner Gibson and Chief Harzog has put together, everyone attending the State Fair will feel safe. They will know that we are here for them. Just a little bit about what Capitol Police has done already. Like Commissioner Gibson said, I've only been here for about 4 months now. But when I joined in May 23rd, Capitol Police had approximately 66 law enforcement officers. That number has grown to about 107 now. Also, we have beefed up our patrol units to where, you know, we're running 8 to 10 patrolmen dedicated to patrol every night. Now, like I said, without giving away any kind of security measures, I can assure you that what we provide here for the security detail at the fair is not going to be our only presence. We are still out there in the city. We are still covering our beats within the city. We are also utilizing the efforts out in the city to help enforce the efforts here. So what we have here just visible on the fairgrounds is not going to be all that's here for Capitol Police. And like I said, none of that would be possible without the help of all of our partners in building this front and this team. Also, I'd like to take a second to thank Commissioner Sean Tindall, who couldn't be here today. He has another appointment to be at. But I'd like to thank him for all of his support, and Governor Reeves. They have been there for us. They have asked us numerous times, what is it you need? What can we do to make things better? Colonel Ginn, so many times we've called on him to help us out. Mississippi Highway Patrol, I think there's been more gray cars in the city of Jackson in the last 4 or 5 months than probably ever before. But like I said, we couldn't do this alone. Every bit of success and progress that we've made, it is due in part to the individuals in this room, and also the men and women that I've brought on to my team since being there. But again, we're not taking the job lightly. We're going to continue to boost safety and security throughout the Capitol City Complex, not just for the fair, but after in years to come. And thank you again, Commissioner Gibson. I'm looking forward to working with you more. Looking forward to the State Fair, and I hope to see a lot of friends and family come out and enjoy their time here.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Appreciate you. Thank you. Thank you. We do as well. Chief Ricky Davis, State Fire Marshal's Office. Ricky's been a friend a long time, and you may not realize this, the public may not, but if you come to the fair, you see the State Fire Marshal's Office here. Ricky Davis is here today, and he's going to share a few words. I appreciate their commitment to the effort, and I really appreciate them providing these highly trained canine detection dogs that they brought and they'll have throughout the fairgrounds during the fair, October 6th through 16th. So thank you. We got one here today. You can tell us what the dog's name is, all right? Thank you, Ricky. Appreciate you.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you, Commissioner. It is an honor to be here today, and I want to thank you for this building. I want to thank you and Mark for the job that y'all done in putting this great team together. And the Fire Marshal's Office, is representing the Fire Marshal's Office, an honor to be a part of this great team. Like the Commissioner said, we do several things here at the State Fair. One thing that we do is that every day, morning and evening, we have inspectors to go through every booth on the fairgrounds. We inspect propane, make sure that's all safe. Every vendor here uses propane, so we have to check that every single day to make sure all that's safe. We also check the vent hood systems on every vendor to make sure that the fire suppression system, everything is working good. We also have a fire safety booth that we set up to try to educate our children and adults in fire safety and prevention. And then the other part we do is help with the security. I've been here, this is my 17th fair. I guess I just told how old I was, huh? This is my 17th fair, and I can truly say that the plan that has been put together is the safest plan that I've been a part of in the last 17 years. And thank you, Chief, for helping put all this together. And I believe that. I called my daughter, I talked to my daughter and her husband, and I said, I want y'all to be sure that you come to the fair this year, bring the kids. I would not have said that if I didn't truly believe that this would be one of the safest fairs that we ever put on. But I am honored to be a part of this. I want to thank Commissioner Mike Chaney for allowing us to be a part of this. The commissioner mentioned our dogs. We do have, we will have a canines here every night through the state fair. Those dogs are canines, are highly trained. We have one today. His name is Persian. And so they will be here throughout the fair, along with the other fire marshals working alongside all these great other state agencies. So we appreciate everything you've done for us.
Appreciate you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yes, appreciate you. Thanks for all y'all do. Hinds County Sheriff Tyree Jones, we've gotten to be friends, and he has hit the ground running here in Hinds County. I really appreciate the enthusiasm he brings as well, and appreciate all their help over the years and this year too. Thank you, Sheriff, for being with us. Thank you. Appreciate you.
Good morning, everyone. First of all, thank you, Commissioner Gibson, for all the efforts and the activity you have put into planning what we anticipate to be a very safe venue and event that will be family-oriented, of course, as well. The Hinds County Sheriff's Office looks forward to working collectively with all of the partners involved in this event. We know that there will be success with all of the stakeholders that we have involved as well. The Hinds County Sheriff's Office, the men and women, will be here at the fairgrounds throughout all hours of operation, as well as after hours, as well providing security, logistic resources to the men and women that will be attending the state fair as well. We look forward to this. We look forward to working alongside the newly formed Mississippi Highway Patrol Mounted Unit, along with our Mounted Unit as well, to be able to provide more presence and resources to the state fair and to the venue as well. Again, thank you for this opportunity. We are very excited about this. And again, we look forward to a very safe, family-oriented state fair this year and the many years to come after this year as well. Thank you all again.
Thank you, Sheriff. Thank you very much. Appreciate you. And of course, last but not least, is our Chief James Davis of Jackson Police Department. I asked the Chief to say a word of prayer just before we hoisted the law enforcement flag outside in anticipation of the fair, but also for the safety of the people, everyone that comes to the fair, and those who don't come to the fair. We appreciate all that you do, and would you come say a few words for us? And I'm going to ask you to hang around a few minutes and close us in prayer in just a minute, all right? Okay, thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Well, good morning, everyone. Like the commissioner said, I'm James Davis, serving Chief of Police, City of Jackson. And I just want to thank, commend Commissioner Andy Gibson. Let's give him a round of applause. Let me tell you, Commissioner taking the bull by the horn. Throughout my time as serving as chief and deputy chief commanders, it's the first time I have seen and witnessed law enforcement come together. And of course, as you see all across the country, there is a surge of violent crime in America. But I truly believe, like on this state, Emmerem, that it's in God we trust. Commission asked me to open up with prayer. That's important. Because I get the calls from citizens all across Jackson, all across the state of Mississippi, all of Mississippians. They want to be safe. They want to come to the state fair. They want to be involved in activities in our capital city. So I am extremely proud to be a part of this event. I'm proud of all the law enforcement that coming together on one accord, and that is to provide safety for our capital city. So may God bless this event, and I'm extremely proud, and you'll see Jackson Police Department like you've always seen them every single year. When traffic bagged up on the interstate, you see Jackson Police Department directing traffic. We'll be at the traffic light. We'll be all in the dark areas where people park. Families get out of their cars so excited, they leave their cars unlocked. We'll be out there to make sure that these bad actors don't take advantage of all our Mississippians. And many people, not only Mississippians, I get calls from people from other states coming to the state fair. So I'm anticipating a great year. I'm anticipating eating some of Commissioner biscuits. I am committed. We at the Jackson Police Department are committed to providing the best possible public safety in and surrounding our state capital. Thank you. All right, commission asked me to pray. So if we can go before the throne of grace, everybody bow and join with me. Dear Lord, we come before you. We come to your throne of grace. We ask that you send your spirit. May your spirit hover over this fairgrounds. Your spirit hover over our state capital. May your spirit hover over the city of Jackson and all Mississippi. And may you bring peace and order and safety to our capital city and our fairgrounds. In the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we agree in prayer and say amen.
Amen. Thank you so much. Let's give Chief a hand. Thank you for what you do. All right. Well, I want to mention a few of the highlights, and then I'll take questions from the press. But we are geared up. We're ready to go for the state fair. As I mentioned, this building will open on October the 5th, the day before the state fair. The ribbon cutting for the fair will happen at 11 o'clock at our normal location on October the 6th. That's a Thursday. And we invite everybody to come out to be a part of it. I believe it's going to be cooler by then, don't y'all? I just believe it is. I think it's the hottest first day of fall we've ever seen, but they tell me a cold front is on the way. And when the fair comes to town, it usually does. This year we've got some new things that families can come enjoy, included with your cost of admission. It's $5 to park, $5 admission. The normal admission price includes a brand new show we're bringing called the Great American Wild West Show. It is a great patriotic celebration of America, of the West, and but they tell me Buffalo Bill Cody and Annie Oakley are going to be here, all right, riding on horseback at the ribbon cutting. I'm looking forward to that. We're going to have, of course, all of the rides, the games, the food, concerts that are happening, livestock shows. Families from all over Mississippi are coming here to show their livestock. Our 4-H and FFA kids will be here. Don't forget the Ag Expo in the Trademark. It's a great location. If it does get hot, it's always cool inside the Mississippi Trademark. A great trade show for agriculture we'll have there. And our Genuine Mississippi store. We're going to have on Saturday night an extreme bull riding event, and then a tri-state rodeo on that Sunday. And we invite you to be part of that. And then the next weekend, the horse pool, pony pool, mule pool, and all that good stuff. $5 to park, $5 per person. Children 6 and under are admitted free. You can get your tickets in advance at the Coliseum box office 11 a.m. until 11 a.m. Thursday. And we're going to be opening the program on October the 6th. It'll run through the 16th. And get all the details at our brand new website. We put a website up that has not only the fair, but all the events that are happening on the fairgrounds. And we have a lot at MississippiFairgrounds.com. Follow the Mississippi State Fairgrounds Facebook, Instagram, Twitter page. And I want to invite you all, as I will be here for the Mississippi State Fair, I want you to come join us and come enjoy a fresh, hot, homemade buttermilk biscuit and syrup. It's going to be great like it always is. Thanks to our good sponsors and our employees that work hard to bake them for you. Thank you all for coming. I'll take any questions now from the press. If you have any, yes. Yeah, the question is how many officers will be here on site during the fair. That is going to change with the size of the crowd that we have. The folks here at the Department of Agriculture have been doing this a long time, and we sort of know what that flow looks like. If we have more people than expected, we can respond immediately to up that amount, but there will be multiple, not only multiple officers, dozens of officers, scores of officers, but multiple agencies in different zones around the fairgrounds. You will see them, and there will be plenty of them. You will feel safe when you're here. Thank you. Any other questions? I don't see any. Well, thank you. Let's give our law enforcement one more hand. Thank you for what you're doing to keep us safe. And starting tomorrow, the 23rd, we're going to begin our advertisement campaign for the State Fair. You'll be seeing those ads. And you get ready to come enjoy a great family-friendly Mississippi State Fair. It's for all Mississippians, and we welcome you to join us. Thank you all for being here today.